All right, welcome back to B58 Advanced PLC Programming. Today I'm going to walk through the steps to make a new project and get the project talking to a PLC. And before we start with the software, I want to go take a look at the PLC. We'll talk about that a little bit. So let's go over here, and I've got my other camera set up here. Here's our Control Logics PLC. And you notice it's got seven slots, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And the location for each, it's not 1 through 7, it's 0 through 6. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And let's see what we've got here. We've got our controller in slot 0, and we've got some inputs and outputs, analog. We've got an Ethernet IP communication card in slot 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Slot 4 has the communication card. And then we've got a few more inputs and outputs. Now to talk to this PLC, we're talking over Ethernet. So here's our Ethernet cable. That talks to the communication card, which talks to the backplane, and the backplane talks to the controller. We need to find this controller in Studio 5000, and to do that, first of all, we need to know this IP address. So it's 10.4.56.35. All right, let's go start up Studio 5000. I'll make a new project, and the one we're using is the 1756L71, and that matches our controller. And I'm going to call this sample. We'll call it sample 1. And I'll hit next. Now here we've only currently got revision 30 of the Studio 5000 installed, so that's what we're using. And this one's really important. Most of these computers in the lab default to 10 slot chassis. If you leave it at 10 slot chassis, it's not going to work. You need to set that to 7 slot. Slot 0, that's the slot location for the controller. And this PLC that we're going to talk to, the controller's in slot 0. And we're good to go. So I'll hit finish, and this is going to take about a minute to load. All right, that took about a minute. Now let's see what we've got here. We've got Studio 5000 up. And if we look down at the bottom, we've got, we're showing a controller, but we're not online. So this is whatever was used last time. I'm going to go online with that PLC, and then we'll get some setup done. So I'll go to communication, who active, and I want to use Ethernet IP to communicate. So I'll expand that. And this is going to show every PLC in the lab. Notice in the lab here, there some are X'd out, and that's just because the power is not turned on. And I wanted to talk to number 35. So 10.4.56.35. I get that from the communication module. So it's showing some status, 10.4.56.35. So that's my IP address. That's the IP address of the communication card. I can't talk with the communication card. I can only use it as a pathway to the controller. I'm going to expand that, and now I can see the backplane. Expand it again, and now I can see everything that's on that PLC. So I'll click on the controller. Notice if I'm clicked on the backplane, I can't go online. Notice if I'm clicked on the communication card, I don't have the option to go online or upload. Same with the backplane, because I can't talk to a backplane. But when I click on the controller, now I have the options. So click on the controller, and now I'm going to go online. Okay, when I do this, notice these green lights here. Right now I've got two green, a gray, and then another green for IO OK. But let me download, because I'm not fully communicating with this controller yet. Now what I'm doing is I'm downloading what's in Studio 5000 to that PLC, to the PLC controller.
All right.
So now I'm online. I've got green lights here, but notice it says I/O not present. And that's because I haven't configured any of my modules. If I look down here, I've got, it's showing the backplane and it's showing the controller, but it's not showing any of those inputs and outputs. What I'm going to do is right click on the backplane and discover modules. Now it gives me a list. Here's the backplane, and I've got, looks like, six modules. So the first one, I'm going to create it, and we'll go look at that PLC again for a second. So notice we've got input module, output, and analog, and then in and out in these ones. So I'm going to just be concerned with input, output, and analog right now. So that first one, I'm going to call it input. And I don't have to give it a name here, but it makes it more organized if I do. I could even give it a description if I want. Hit OK a few times. And now I've got my input module. Let's go look at our tags for a minute. If I go up to the top in controller tags and open that, I've got local one input and calibration. I'm not using calibration. But here's all my 16 input locations on that card. I'll go back to configuration, right click, discover modules again. Notice that first one, no action needed, module exists. I'm going to create the second one. That's my output. Hit OK a few times. And now in my controller tags, I'm showing local one inputs. And here's my local two. There's my outputs. Now I'm just going to do one more module. So right click on configuration, discover. Now I'll do this third one. And that's my analogs. Okay, so I've got local one, two, and three in my tags down here. It shows my modules. There's my inputs, my outputs, and my analogs. Now, if I look up here, I've got a steady green light for input, output, okay. To know if you're talking to your PLC, you have to have all three of these guys green. If they're not all green, then you're not properly talking and you need to find out why you're not talking. Something's not configured right, or maybe you're just not on run mode. So if I go here, set that to program mode, and notice my green light goes out, so I'm not really in the right mode. So I'll go back to run mode, and now I've got all three green. All right, let's go over the steps real quick again. First thing is I have to talk to my PLC. So I go to communication, who active. I need to know where that Ethernet card is, so I need the IP address. And if I want to switch controllers, let's see, I'm going to go offline. So now I'm not online with any PLC. I'm going to go to communication, who active, and let this update. I clicked on a PLC that's not active. So this guy right here, this is number 46. So I'm going to try talking to 46. So there it is there. And notice in 46, the program that's currently in 46 is sample. So I'm going to go there and go online with 46. And I'll download. Now I'm downloading what I have in my Studio 5000 to 46. And I'm online with a different PLC now. Notice I've got all three green lights, so I'm good to go with that. If I go up here under tasks, main program, expand that and go to my main routine. And here's where I can start putting in my ladder logic, assuming I want to use ladder logic. Okay, that's all there is to setting up a new project in Studio 5.